When can I see you again?
Sooner the better.
Tomorrow?
Yeah.
Can I get out that way? Thanks for today.
Thank you.
I'll call you in the morning.
Why do I always change my mind when I get them home?
It's fine, Mother.
Oh, I hope you're right. Oh, my feet are killing me. Oh. What did you do today?
Oh, not much. Sat around and got bored. Oh, the doctor came.
Oh, of course. What did he say?
I'll live.
I should hope so. No calls, Simon, Toby?
No calls.
Oh, you must have been bored, poor darling.
Not really. Watched a bit of television for a while.
So how's the little invalid? Oh, I have one of those while you're at it.
Did you get the horse all right?
Did your friend stay long?
Gave her a clean bill of health.
Oh, is he a doctor as well?
Who are you talking about?
The guy who helped her yesterday, Scott, wasn't it?
She lied to me, Gordon. She knows what I think of the boy, and she deliberately went behind my back. I don't think there's anything amusing about it.
I think you're overreacting. Just because he's not on your list doesn't mean he's not a perfectly pleasant young man.
That is beside the point. It's the fact that she lied to me that I am angry about.
All right, leave it with me. I'll talk to her.
Thank you. I'm not being difficult. There are plenty of nice young men interested in her. Doesn't give them the time of day. And she invites a complete stranger into the house. Well, it's about time she got her priorities right.
Give me 10 minutes, then send her in.
The father wants to talk to you later. Patricia Hamilton speaking. Hello, Simon. How are you? Yes, she is. Just hold the line. I'll get her for you.
Tell him I'm asleep or something.
Oh. Is that you, Johnny?
Right.
They to butter me up.
Jill told you.
Jill told me.
I can't take you seriously. You'll never get it out by attacking it.
It's the nearest thing to wringing your neck.
I know all the arguments are against me going.
It won't be much consolation in jail, darling. Oh, they're lovely. Thanks. Been with her all day?
No. I've done a lot of walking, a lot of thinking.
And?
I want to keep seeing her. I'll take the chance. Does it sound that crazy that I dreamt about her even before I saw her? I don't know what's going on.
Maybe it's a warning. All right. Serious. Now, I've stuck my neck out to help you. And I don't want to see us both getting into trouble because you've stumbled across your dream girl.
If I keep seeing her, you'll chuck me out?
Oh, of course not. Don't be stupid. I just want you to have a bit of common sense.
I'll take things slowly, I promise. If I keep pretty low-key, you know, don't get too heavy, I can't see why her parents will freak. Who knows? Once I get to know her, I might run for my life.
It's happened before. Is that a promise?
That I'll keep things slow. Mm-hmm. I really appreciate what you're doing for me, Aunt Fiona. It's the least I can do for you.
Oh, boy. Well, not necessary. 15. Great play in that point, though.
Oh, that's a good point.
Turn it down, love. You know your dad's trying to sleep.
Well, the Australians have got the breakup served back. Remember, three games to come in the second set.
Come in, Lynn.
Hi.
Kevin, Lynn's here. Here I am telling him to be quiet.
Was Mr. Palmer got a job tonight?
Yes, an early start. He's going to Adelaide.
Great.
Hi. Is Susan here?
No, she's with Bill.
Oh, there's just something I had to talk about.
Well, drop in before school tomorrow and you'll catch up.
Oh.
Actually, I'm glad you're here. I've got some bad news for you.
Well, the wedding's off. That's where Susan's gone, to tell Bill.
Well, you certainly get your tact from your father. I'm sorry, love. I know how much you're looking forward to being a bridesmaid.
Oh, yeah. I'm sorry. How's Susan? I mean, she must be pretty upset.
Well, I can't say I agree with her decision, but it's her life.
I've got something to show you. Let her come in here before she starts crying on your shoulder.
Go on, off you go. His trouble is he knows his mum too well.
Mm. Come on. Well?
You're asking for trouble.
All that stuff I've had laid on me about John. I'm setting the record straight, that's all.
In the school paper, though.
In the editor, why not?
Yeah, why not?
And if John's family won't stick up for him, who will?
You know what your problem is? You haven't got the guts to ignore what other people are saying.
I'm not calling off the wedding, I'm just postponing it.
Right, you're giving in.
Why do you keep your voice down like such a mother?
Well, you think she's not going to be upset anyway?
She's not as unreasonable as Lou. This, you see my point.
All this stuff about me not having a job is so much bull.
Oh, sure, we could live on a trainee nurse's wage.
If you loved me, we could.
Okay, it did start with worrying about John and what people were saying. But it's other things on top of that. I want everything to be so right. I don't see why waiting a few months makes so much difference.
It's giving in.
You won't even try and understand, will you? Talk to you tomorrow. I'm not in the mood for any more tonight.
I'm not going
to
feel any different.
Neither am I.
Susan! Oh, damn. Hello.
Could I speak to Bill Todd, please?
Speaking.
It's Margaret Selmer here, Bill. I was wondering if you could come into the warehouse in the morning. There's something important I'd like to discuss with you. As you see, I'm in a difficult position.
I don't quite see what you expect me to do about it.
Because Sam fired you and John Palmer on the day he died, I've been left running the place with virtually inexperienced staff. I was hoping you might come back.
Oh, I don't think I could. Sorry.
Oh, I can understand why you're hesitant.
What do you mean?
Well, you're marrying the Palmer girl.
Oh, that's got nothing to do with it.
Do you mind me asking what it is then?
Well, when Sam fired me, I was thinking of leaving anyway, to find something different.
How does this sound? If you come back, you'll have much more responsibility. I'll want you, virtually to fill Sam's shoes. And of course, that'll mean more money.
I'm saving to get married. I've just taken out a mortgage on a new house.
You should have thought of that before you started fooling around with that other clown.
Give me a chance.
No. I'll put two new men on. They start tomorrow.
Okay, you owe me a week's money. I want it.
Some kind of a joke. You're asking me for money after what you cost me today.
I've got to have it.
I'll show you how mean I can be.
Now, wait a minute. This is between you and me.
Don't make things worse for yourself.
Bill, how does that sound to you?
Sorry? Oh, fine. Could I think about it, okay?
Of course.
Your problem, Mother, is you're a snob.
What's snobbish about wanting the best for you?
Best for you, you mean.
I don't think that's fair.
Oh, isn't it?
Don't disturb your father. He's talking business with Wayne.
Well, I'll wait then. At least he's on my side.
That's only because you can twist him around your little finger. If he'd stop and think for a minute, he'd realize that I'm right.
Oh, you know, it'd do you good to talk to someone like Scott. I mean, at least you'd see that there aren't two sets of people, us and them.
It'd be ridiculous.
I don't think it's ridiculous.
What's the point in us giving you a good education, introducing you to the right people, if you're going to go gaga over some boy you know nothing about?
I like him a lot. That's all I need to know at the moment.
I think Mother's got a point.
Let them answer it. Stop them arguing. I've got enough financial worries in other areas without the stud going bad on me. You'll just have to cut costs.
That's easier said than done.
Spend a bit of time out there, and you might find a way.
You're the boss.
I knew it'd be you.
I would have phoned earlier, except I slept in.
You
sound as bad as me.
I really enjoyed yesterday. I hope you didn't cop any flack from your parents.
No, of course not. They did find out, though.
They're okay about it?
Fine. In fact, more than fine. Mummy was just saying that she'd love you to come over to dinner tonight. How about it?
I'll get it, Mum.
Hi.
Come in.
I'm sorry about last night.
I'm sorry, too.
Hey, how important is my having a job? I mean, would it change your mind about the wedding?
You got one?
I've been offered one.
You're going to take it, aren't you?
It would mean going back to Selma's.
Oh. Well, how do you feel about that?
Look, you haven't answered my question. If I took it, would it change your mind about the wedding?
I guess so.
Okay, I'll ring Mrs. Selma. Can I use the phone?
Yes, sure. And don't worry about Mum and Dad, they'll understand.
Yeah, I know that.
What have we been so serious about? We should be celebrating. I love you. Oh.
Hello, you two.
Hi. I just dumped my bag, won't be a tick.
Okay. You off out again?
No, no. It's gonna help Kevin clean up the shed.
Oh, trust him. Oh, well, good news. The wedding's back on.
Oh, when did that happen?
This morning. You don't sound too pleased about it.
Oh, no. No, no, that's great.
What's wrong, love?
Oh, I'm sorry, Mrs. Palmer. I came in last night to tell you. When I heard the wedding was off, I just didn't bother.
Tell me what?
It's Mum and Dad. They said I can't be Susan's bridesmaid.
Oh.
Thanks for letting me know, Mum. Yeah, I'm fine. See you when I get home. Bye. Lynn's parents won't let her be bridesmaid.
How come?
Apparently they don't want her getting tied up in any of the publicity.
What publicity?
After what happened, I guess they expect the wedding will be on the news or something. Funny people. Oh, don't get cross. It's Lynn I feel sorry for. Mum said she was crying by the time she left.
So what are you going to do?
Forget about it. I let things get me down once before. I'm not going to again.
Can't stay. Mum and Dad think I'm studying.
You all right?
Yeah. I'm sorry.
No, it's okay. It's not your fault.
Doesn't affect us, does it?
Of course it doesn't.
Good. That's all I wanted to know.
How do I look? Respectable?
I'd trust you with the family jewels.
Hey?
I think you're probably a bit young for that one, dear.
I'm glad you're taking this, okay?
Well, just be careful. Remember what you promised. Slowly does it.
Right. See ya.
Well, what do you think?
I doubt whether he'll notice.
Oh, darling, don't be so paranoid.
All I mean is that men don't notice these things. Your father's exactly the same.
Sorry.
I told you. You want to play your little game, I'll play along with you. At least I'll prove I'm not a snob.
I hope so.
Oh, your father wants to see you. He's in the study.
Where are they? And you will try, won't you?
Oh, I'll be on my best behavior. Oh. That is tarnished. I'd hate to have to speak to the agency.
Getting excited.
What's so different about Scott Edwards?
What do you mean?
Well, it's not your usual pattern with his type. I mean, one night in the back seat of a car, and thank you very much.
Shh, keep your voice down.
Sorry, can't go disillusioning Daddy, can we?
No, we can't, can we?
All right. It was just a civil question.
Of course it was.
So why is he different? Why the dinner invitation?
You'll be the last to know.
Yes?
Wait a minute, love.
Looks so boring.
I'll tell you a secret. It is.
Are you angry with me?
What makes you think that?
Mother made it sound so serious. Your father wants to see you. I only invited Scott to teach her a lesson.
It's not very fair on the young man, is it?
I think you'll like him.
You haven't answered my question.
You are cross.
Angela.
Oh, all right. Maybe it was unfair. But I'm glad I did it.
You didn't get the rise out of your mother you wanted.
The night's not over yet.
Now you listen to me, young lady. I'm telling you the same thing as I told her. Scott Edwards is going to be a guest in this house, and I don't want him ending up as the ball in a ping-pong match between you two.
I'm only joking, Daddy. I like him too much to do that.
Really?
Really. It's funny, I've only met him a few times, but I feel like I've known him for ages. Maybe that's what they call love at first sight.
Don't let your mother hear that. She'll have a coronary. I'm looking forward to meeting him.
I'm glad.
Can I get you a drink?
Yes, thank you, darling. Campari and soda.
You're taking it very calmly.
Oh, what else can I do except rant and rave, and that never gets me very far with your sister.
You're giving in then?
Oh, I didn't say that. No, I've got plans for Angela's future, and Scott Thingamabob doesn't feature in them.
I wouldn't worry. She'll get bored with him quickly enough.
Better sooner than later. This evening, preferably.
What is your plan?
Create an atmosphere where he can show himself for what he is, a fish out of water. I'm going to enjoy this evening. Hello, Scott. I'm so pleased you could make it. We've been looking forward to meeting you.
I bought this for you.
How very thoughtful. Oh, Mrs. Gray, could you put this in the kitchen, please? Oh, shall we go in and join the others?
I'm glad you could make it, Scott. I've been wanting to thank you for looking after my girl.
Daddy's having a medal struck.
Oh, don't embarrass the poor boy, you two. Scott?
Oh, thanks.
You're not related to the Edwards of Alona Avenue by any chance, are you?
No.
Oh. I thought you might have been visiting them. And Dural's rather a long way out if you don't have friends here.
I was sightseeing.
Oh, you're a visitor to Sydney, then?
I've just moved here.
From?
Brisbane.
Nice city.
If you like overgrown country towns.
I've never heard you complaining at Woombye. Oh, we've got a place up north. We go there for holidays.
Yeah? Well, my grandparents live in the country. We go there a fair bit.
Well, where's there?
Ararat.
That's rather a long trip from Brisbane.
Yeah, well, we don't go there that much. Special occasions, you know.
And what does your father do?
His job.
Yes.
He's manual work.
Yes, I think we'll go into dinner now. Don't bolt your food, Lance.
It's my favourite.
Have a good day at school.
Okay.
Did you get the paper out on time?
Yeah.
Where's my copy?
Oh, I forgot it.
Oh, that'd be a first.
I'll bring you one tomorrow. I better do my homework.
Sit down and finish your meal properly.
I've got a lot to do, Mum.
All right. Bring your cup of tea later. In the meantime, take this.
Oh, I'll skip sweets.
Change your mind?
Yeah.
Anybody would think I never taught you kids any manners?
Oh,
hope you like brichoises.
I'll try anything once.
Actually, it's plain old leek and potato soup.
Poor lad. More Monday, 1:30.
Love is very strange. It can come and go.
It can happen when you are young or old.
When it comes from nowhere. When it comes, it changes your life. Sons and daughters, love and laughter, tears and sadness and happiness. We will find out our sons and daughters are what we two were once about.